One local woman's mission to help a paralyzed girl in Africa puts the entire hospital on a mission to save her young life. Ann Bowden went to Floyd Memorial Hospital to be introduced to Matilda. Ann?
Well, Rick, 12-year-old Matilda Figo is from Zambia. Her parents, one is too ill to care for her, another is now deceased. And for most of her life, she stayed in an orphanage, but it took one chance meeting with a head nurse at Floyd Memorial Hospital to change Matilda's life completely.
I like everything that I do. I like playing, everything. Just like it.
12-year-old Matilda Figo has come a long way. Her English has improved, so has her health. But rewind 3 years ago.
Well, I first met Matilda in 2008 when I went to Zambia on a mission trip.
Kayla Cook, the manager of Floyd Memorial Hospital Surgery Unit, met Matilda in her hut in Zambia. Matilda stayed in Cook's memory.
Well, she was in my heart since 2008, but I went back in 2011, May 2011, again, and that's when I got to know her better.
With no parents, she stayed in an orphanage that tried to accommodate her crippling spinal tuberculosis. Malnourished and with significant burns on her body due to what may have been folk medicine, Kayla set out to get Matilda treatment. After cutting through government red tape to get her x-rays sent to the States, Dr. Michael Doyle at Floyd Memorial finally received them.
Probably within a day, he called me, and he was just very excited, but he was like, Kayla, what in the world has happened to this kid? And he said, I think I can help her. If you can get her over here, I think I can help her.
What astounded me was that she was getting around at all, because basically there was no spinal cord. It was being compressed so badly.
With a call to Floyd Memorial's CEO, a plan was approved to call Zambian officials to ask if the hospital could host Matilda and help in her recovery. Floyd Memorial paid for her travel, an extensive surgery on her spinal cord, and everything she needed for recovery.
Just great, just great.
Since her surgery, Matilda has experienced her first snow, is riding a specially made bike, and even riding horses. It's a recovery that took a hospital community and her strong will.
Playing videos, reading some time, and trying to do homework schools.
Now, Floyd Memorial did all of this out of pocket. No grant was used. And now, Kosher Children's Hospital is also helping. They are funding another surgery for Matilda to help correct a congenital hip disorder that doctors discovered. Now, if you're wondering if there are workings to see if Matilda will become a part of Kayla's family and Floyd Memorial Hospital's family permanently, that is in the works. Ann Bowden, WLKY News.